Bannon and Ingraham team up to help outsider unseat anti-Trump Senator Jeff Flake. It was just over the weekend that Stephen Bannon told an audience at the Values Voters Summit. "This is our war. The establishment started it. You all are gonna finish it." Of course, that was also when he called Senator Bob Corker, TNR, a real piece of work too. Most importantly though, Bannon said, "Nobody can run and hide. The day of taking a few conservative votes and running and hiding, is over." Bannon was not kidding. Now, he's teamed up with fellow conservative and radio talk show host Laura Ingraham to take on Senator Jeff Flake, SR. Tuesday night, Bannon and Ingraham were on hand to launch Dr. Kelly Ward's bid to unseat Flake in Scottsdale. "This revolt is going from Alabama to Arizona," Bannon proclaimed in a reference to Judge Roy Moore's win over Senator Luther Strange in the Alabama Republican primary special election last month, despite Strange's support from Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell. Bannon told the crowd of hundreds on hand he is backing candidates like Moore and Ward because they will support President Donald Trump's agenda, not the GOP establishment's. Ingraham said, "It's time to melt the snowflake." The conservative firebrand contended that Flake's willingness to give away the Supreme Court by not supporting Trump's candidacy last fall disqualified him to continue as a Republican senator. Flake, who has been a very vocal critic of President Trump, is the least popular senator up for re-election, according to a Morning Consult poll conducted this summer. The survey found just 37% approved of his job performance, while 45% disapproved. Only McConnell and Flake's fellow Arizonan Senator John McCain had worse numbers, but neither of them is up for re-election in 2018. Ward, who was first elected to Arizona State Senate in 2012, currently has a double-digit lead over Flake in polling. Ward resigned her seat in December 2015 to challenge McCain and garnered nearly 40% of the vote in a field of four candidates to McCain's 52%. Which was his lowest re-election bid tally. The candidate tied herself closely to Trump's policies at her kickoff rally Tuesday, saying she supports the full repeal of Obamacare and building a border wall. "I'm a liberty-loving constitutional conservative that's ready to go to Washington and drain the swamp," Ward said. Asked at the White House on Monday morning whether he approved of Bannon's war on the establishment, Trump said he understood the sentiment, noting that senators are not getting the job done. "There are some Republicans, frankly, that should be ashamed of themselves," Trump said, but added that most of the Republican senators he's gotten to know are really great people. There seems little doubt Flake was not one of the great people to which Trump was referring. The president welcomed Ward's challenge of the incumbent, tweeting in August, "Great to see that Dr. Kelly Ward is running against Flake Jeff Flake, who is weak on borders, crime and a non-factor in Senate. He's toxic." 5:56 a.m. August 17, 2017. According to Ward top campaign strategist Eric Beach, his candidate has raised over $1 million to date in her bid to unseat Flake, which clearly gives her the resources to compete. "Well, it should be an interesting campaign to watch." As Bannon also said earlier, no one is safe except for Ted Cruz. Bannon is looking to challenge every sitting GOP lawmaker in the 2018 midterm elections, except for Cruz. Bannon and his PAC are going to take on every GOP establishment incumbent in every state. After that, Bannon will go after Democrats. "It's the establishment on both sides of the aisle that have been unwilling to support and advance Trump's agenda. Now, it's time for them to be held accountable. If they aren't going to support Trump, then they better be ready to be replaced by someone who will." From Alabama to Arizona, the Great American Alliance is headed your way.